Hi all, welcome to my channel Agile Enthusiast. I'm Mahendra Hote. In this channel, I'll be posting videos on the various Agile topics and share my learning. And in the process, the takeaway for me is I will learn something from the comments I get, and more importantly, creating these videos enables me to reflect and validate my learning as well. The agenda for this tutorial is: first, we will understand what Wsjf is, weighted shortest job first. Wsjf is its definition and characteristics. Next, we'll learn the details of Wsjf. Then I'll be showing Microsoft Excel calculator for calculating Wsjf and show you a screenshot how it is in version 1, how Wsjf is calculated in version 1. Version 1 is one of the popular Agile lifecycle management tools. The last point in the agenda is what I find interesting. I would be validating Wsjf as a concept by using 4 projects with dummy values. So let's get started. At the outset, I would like to mention that I have referred to quite a few articles and websites to come up with this material and would like to acknowledge them first. Thanks to all the authors of these websites and those articles and books, which I am not able to recollect readily. Wsjf stands for Weighted Shortest Job First. It is a prioritization technique which is used to decide the priority amongst the various epochs or features that the team is expected to work and produce maximum economic benefit. The characteristics of Wsjf are: it takes an economic view to prioritize. It helps us pick up the most value-producing feature or an epic with the least cost and risk. It ignores sunk costs. Sunk costs is the cost that is already invested in the particular project or feature. The entire focus is on cost of delay, as Don Reniston says. If you have to quantify one thing, then quantify the cost of delay. Higher the Wsjf score, higher is the priority. It is a technique which enables us to compare the various opportunities at hand with varying degree of value and urgency. It as well takes into account of the situation where the duration is also different for each of these features or apex. Safe scaled agile framework emphasizes that Wsjf should be applied at the feature level. In the safe construct, job size is used as a proxy for duration. We will see what this means in the coming slides. In the safe construct, again, it is advised to use Fibonacci series for all the parameters and fill up one column at a time. What I mean by one column at a time, we'll see in the subsequent slides. Now, for the formula of Wsjf, it is the cost of delay. Let me use my options. It is the cost of delay divided by the duration. It is easy to remember the same by using the acronym CD3, cost of delay divided by duration. CD3 is the acronym, cost of delay divided by duration. This is the formula for Wsjf. Now let's get into the details of the formula. Cost of delay consists of 3 components: business value, time criticality, and risk reduction or opportunity enablement. Business value. This is the component from a business and a revenue generation point of view. If the users are really desperate for this feature in comparison to the ones on the list, then this feature gets a higher value. If the cost to market share of this feature not being delivered in comparison to the rest of the list, then this gets a higher number. This particular feature gets a higher number. If a particular feature has a higher negative impact, if not acted upon, then this feature gets a higher number. It basically revolves around the business value and the impact that it would have if not delivered. The feature which has the least value gets one, the rest are relatively sized to it. Next, coming to the time criticality. If this feature needs to be launched in comparison to the rest on the list, then this particular feature or epic gets a higher value. If there's a possibility of the value decay over time for this feature or epic at a faster rate in comparison to the rest of the features or epics in the list, then that particular feature gets a higher value. Once again, here the feature which is least critical gets one, and the rest are relatively sized, the number is getting relative to this. Next, coming to the risk reduction or opportunity element. Will implementing this feature or capability reduce the risk throughout the value stream in comparison to the others in the list? Then this gets a higher value. Will implementing this attract new customers? Then it gets a higher value. Is there a possibility that this will open up, this work will open up new avenues? Then it gets a higher value. The feature that does the least for reducing the risk, or which is the least for opportunity enablement, gets a one. Rest are rated relative to this. As you can see from all the three components, all this is pointing towards cost of delay in its own form. Now for the duration. This is a bit tricky. It is rather difficult to determine the duration of the feature or the capability at this early stage at the program or portfolio level, when we don't even know who will work on it and we don't even know the capacity allocation. Hence, we use job size as a proxy over here. Basically, we assume fixed resources. For example, if I'm the only one mowing my lawn and the front yard is three times bigger than the backyard, it's going to take three times longer. That is what is job size as a proxy all about. I've put up a simple Excel spreadsheet with all the components of WSJF, which makes it easier to calculate. I'll show this spreadsheet subsequently. The important thing here is we are always advised to fill up column wise. We are always advised to fill up column wise rather than row wise. And we should use Fibonacci series to fill it up. We can use our good old technique of planning poker here. Consider the business value and fill up all the line items by using relative technique. It may be something like this. You can choose portfolio item 2 as a baseline value with a value of 2, and the rest of the ones are rated relatively to the item 2. Next, take time criticality into consideration and relatively assign a number to each one of the line item, each one of the portfolio item. Likewise, next is the job size. Since the Microsoft Excel is formula driven, the values of cost of delay and WSJF automatically appear. The values of cost of delay and WSJF automatically appear. But it is important to fill up column wise. That is something that we should bear in mind, so that we are giving due consideration to the relative rating technique. If we go on filling row wise, the power of relative rating will be lost. This is what I was mentioning in my earlier slide. Now, let me just quickly show you the spreadsheet that I have put across. It is pretty simple Microsoft Excel spreadsheet. So you can just give the values. I'm just filling it up randomly. Oh, sorry about that. Yeah, this is the Excel spreadsheet. So as you can see, the cost of delay is just the sum of A, B, and C, and WSJF is cost of delay divided by job size. This is a pretty simple Excel spreadsheet. Now, coming back to this is a screenshot from version 1. In version 1, it says that the values can be from 0 to 100. As you can see, the values can be from 0 to 100. I just followed that. But it is always advisable to use Fibonacci series. When we create a portfolio item in version 1, we are given an option to provide the values for A, which is business value, B, it's a risk reduction, C, time criticality. All of these you can give with the range of 0 to 100. And a swag, that is a job duration. Now the tool calculates, version 1 tool calculates the WSJF. It is basically the sum of the business value, risk reduction, time criticality divided by the duration. The tool automatically applies it. Now, to prove the point of WSJF and the ill effects of choosing an incorrect order of execution, I have created this Excel spreadsheet with an example of three portfolio items, A, B, and C. Portfolio items A, B, and C. A having a duration of 1 month and a cost of delay of $1,500 per month. B having a duration of 1 month and a cost of delay of $1,000 per month. And C duration of 4 months with the cost of delay of $5,000 per month. Please note that in this example, I am using absolute figures of months and dollars per month for the duration and cost of delay respectively. This is just to help us get this concept. It will help us understand why we should execute the items in the order prescribed by WSJF and what happens if we do not follow so. As per WSJF, the order of execution should be item A. As per WSJF, the order should be ACB. Item A should be first, C should be second, and B should be last, which has a WSJF value of 1.5k, 1.25k, and 1k respectively. As you can see, choosing the right order of execution has the least financial damage to the company. As per this example, the order of execution should be ACB, which has the least damage, which is 32.5k. Now let me explain this section. Cost of delay while A is being worked is calculated by the duration of A multiplied by the cost of delay of A, B, and C respectively, and taking the sum total of the three, which is 7.5k in this case. What is the cost of delay while C is being worked upon? It is calculated by the duration of C multiplied by the cost of delay of B, multiplied by the cost of delay of B and C respectively, and taking the sum total of the two, which is 24k in this example. Finally, what is the cost of delay while B is being worked upon? It is just the cost of delay associated with B alone, which is the duration of B multiplied by the cost of delay of B, which is 1k. I hope I am clear. As you can see from the above table, only this order of execution ACB has the least financial damage to the company, which is 32.5k. This proves that the fact that we should choose the order of execution as suggested by WSJF to incur the least damage to the company. Now let us see the Excel which I have used for the calculation. Let me explain the Excel spreadsheet. This is an Excel, simple Excel spreadsheet which one can create. This is what I was mentioning. Portfolio item A has a duration of 1 month with 1.5k. So the WSJF is 1.5. Likewise, portfolio item B has a WSJF of 1k and C has a WSJF of 1.25k. So as per WSJF, the order should be A, C, and at the last it is B. And if you do the calculation, this is a verification. By the verification also we see that choosing this order ACB has got the least damage to the company. Now let's assume that the duration of item portfolio item A is 2 months. Now the order of execution as suggested by WSJF is CBA. Now where is CBA? CBA. As you can see, only if you execute, this is a verification, only if you execute in the order of CBA, you have the least damage to the company, which is 35.5K. If you choose any other order, the company will incur a higher cost of delay. So what I was trying to prove here is, it's fine that the material says that when you pick the highest WSJF value and then go by that order. But what if a different order of execution is chosen? That is what I wanted to prove by this calculation. Well, this brings us to the end of this tutorials. Hope you enjoyed it. Request you to leave any comments and clarification, which I would be happy to assist with. Thanks for joining.